being an empath comes with a price. And being an empath also comes at a cost. Now, I've lived most of my life as an empath. I've lived all my life as an empath. But at some point in time, I realized that actually, I hadn't loved myself so much enough, or even so well enough, that I couldn't protect myself. And that is the reason, because I was unawakened to who I really am. So there's two types of empaths. There's the awakened empath, and then there is the unawakened empath. So the unawakened empath is usually the empath who finds themselves in abusive relationships, who find themselves being used, who find themselves giving their all, and actually whatever it is they're giving, it isn't reciprocated. That is because those empaths, they don't really know who they are. On the other hand, the awakened empath is the empath who knows how to protect themselves, and they are the empaths who knows they have discovered who they are, and they understand protecting themselves is also their obligation. As much as they want to help and give people or help people or uplift people, they also have learned how to protect themselves. For the most of my life, I've lived as an unawakened empath. And that is exactly what has happened. And definitely people, because on my page as well, I'm very sure most of you are empaths. You can relate with this. For the most of your lives as an unawakened empath, you have realized that actually you have been giving your whole to people who never get back to you. And that is even some of the cases why we have ended up in very abusive relationships, where we found ourselves giving and giving and giving to individuals, to partners who actually never had anything to offer to us. Now, there is a short story I want to share with you people. As I was growing up, that could have been like about 10 years ago. I was sitting down with a friend, so we're having a discussion. And after the discussion, we were sitting on a couch. So the friend stood up and left. No, actually he was trying to leave. So when I looked where he was sitting, it's like money had slipped out of his pocket and the money had landed on the couch. So I saw this money. I was the one sitting next to him and I saw this money. So I called him actually, because he was almost disappearing out through the door, and I called him back. And I told him, actually, you've left your money behind. Now, that guy was very surprised, and he told me this is the first time he had ever seen anything like that in his life. He had never had anybody call him back because he had left something behind, especially money for this matter. So he had never seen anything like this before. And he told me something. He told me, there is two things that will happen to you. You will either win or you will either lose. Why? He thought I would lose because I was kind enough to give back his money to him. And why I would win? Because at some point in time, I will meet the right people and eventually I will win. Now, that thing confused me for a while and I couldn't really get the whole picture what he was trying to talk about. And then later on, as I kept on going through self-discovery and discovering who I was, I got the whole picture what this man was actually talking about. And then that's when I remembered actually most of my life that I hadn't really loved myself so much enough, or even so well enough to protect myself. And most of the cases, that's why I found myself in very, very difficult circumstances and very difficult situations as an empath, because you find yourself in situations whereby you have got to go in and help, or even sometimes give. And usually, like I've said, most of you on this page, you can resonate. It has really taken a toll on empaths. But at some point later on, people, when I awakened to the truth of who I am, when I awakened that I was an empath, when I finally understood that actually this whole thing made sense because I had lived all my life as an empath. That is the time I started to reflect. I stepped back and I started to reflect on my life. And then I realized that actually I hadn't really loved myself so much enough. And that is when I started shutting doors. I started shutting doors and I started closing my boundaries. I started putting my boundaries and I started closing my borders. And I remember in those same days, I had just left a narcissistic relationship. And I remember the narcissist asking me, she wanted to, the time when I started shutting the doors, the narcissist told me, you know what, it does not matter if you want to answer me or not, because she was trying to ask me something and I didn't want to respond because she hadn't yet realized that I'd awakened. So she wanted some information from me, and so she wanted some specific reactions from me. So I couldn't react. I refused to react. And the narcissist told me that actually it does not matter how you behave or how you want to behave or whatever, because she noticed that I had switched the game. And she couldn't understand why, but I had for some reason switched the game. And she realized this. And she told me that anyhow, we are still going to be connected all our lives. It does not matter if you want to talk to me or not, if you want to communicate with me or not, we shall always be connected. I told her, yes, we shall be connected, but this time around, we shall be connected with boundaries. So I will never accept you, allow you to cross my boundaries. So she noticed that I'd put this wall in the middle and I'd put the boundaries in place. But as well, along my journey, I took an initiative, especially after the awakening, I took an initiative to love myself more. Because I realized that that was the only gift I would ever give myself. As an empath, I had lost so much during the course of my lifetime, and I had gotten into so much trouble just because I was trying to help people. And then somehow, I found a way of understanding what is self-love. My awakening brought me to the realization of exactly what is self-love. And I realized that actually for most of my entire life, I hadn't really loved myself more. So as an empath, you can relate. Most of the cases, we have a tendency of waiting for validation. An unawakened empath will do something and expect some sort of a validation from somebody. Even sometime to make a decision, you would try to do very difficult decisions and you would not know the repercussions of those decisions you're making, because you are simply unawakened. You don't know who you are. So you believe that everybody needs some kind of assistance, everybody needs help, everybody needs advice, everybody needs... And usually we have ended up with broken, very broken individuals. The time the empath will decide that they are going to close their borders, the time the empath decides that now it is time for them to focus on themselves. It has happened to me, and that's why I'm sharing with you in this video. The very moment you are going to decide that it is time for you to love yourself, to understand yourself and to accept yourself 100%, that is the moment everything is going to change in your favor. Because never again you are going to be taken advantage of, never again you're going to end up in an abusive relationship, never again you are going to meet toxic people, whether it is friends, bosses, partners, or even sometime any other individuals. You will understand what is toxicity, and you will understand that toxic people, they can always cross your boundaries and your borders. They don't have limits, they will always cross your boundaries. And you always understand how to protect yourself. Self-love has taught me so much things, so many things recently. It is through self-love that I was able to become the person I am today, because at this point in time, I can do something unapologetically for the first time in my life. I can wake up in the morning and make a decision. I can decide that I'm going to cut off somebody regardless of who they are for the first time in my life. I can decide that a brother is toxic. I can decide a friend is toxic. I can decide a parent is toxic. I will recognize these patterns and I will simply cut them off unapologetically. But at the same time, I will realize there are some people who need help. I will know how and I will know when to help them. And at the same time, protecting myself. And when I stepped into self-love mode, I realized that actually my life turned upside down. Or even, what can I call it? It turned, it changed for the better, if I can use the word like that. My life changed for the better. So basically, self-love, one of the things, I'm talking to the empaths who have just awakened from usually toxic relationships, and usually I'm talking to the empaths also who have awakened to the truth of who they are. Maybe I've discovered you're an empath, or I don't know, there are so many types of empaths, super empath, a yoga, whatever it is. I'm not much of an empath specialist. But whatever it is, if you're an empath, you're an empath, that is it. So if you have awakened to the truth of who you are as an empath, I'm talking to you that your next level of action is going to be self-love. And you shouldn't be worried about showing love to yourself, loving yourself. You can always understand that you don't need validation from anybody. You cannot wait. You don't need to wait for your father to validate you, whatever you're doing. I had an incident recently whereby specific people from my family were hoping that I should wait for their validation. You know what I mean? I knew what I was doing personally, and they thought that I should wait for their validation. And because I refused to wait for that validation, I was called names, and I was thought, and usually they wanted me to think that I was crazy. That is because I refused to take validation from anybody. I started to validate myself for the first time in my life. So as an empath, you are going to understand what is self-love along your journey. Somewhere, if a person was awakened, eventually, you're going to come face to face with self-love. You're going to respect yourself more. You're going to love yourself more. You're going to understand that actually you also need to take care of yourself. Regardless of who is watching, regardless if there's validation or not, you can know when and how to protect yourself and to protect your boundaries so that you can never again fall into very difficult circumstances like you've always done. And self-love, people, it has really changed my life for the better. The very moment I started taking these decisions, that is the moment I noticed people falling out of my circle, because there is people who couldn't understand that Denzel Mose was for the first time loving himself and understanding himself and choosing himself. So there is people who will stop to understand you. They have always understood you before because they could take advantage of you. But now it has come to a point whereby you have closed the gates and they cannot come in anymore. You have shut the doors, they cannot get in anymore. You know who needs to get in and how they need to get in. You can make the rules for yourself. And some people will not accept that, especially if you have been involved with toxic people. And again, it does not matter whether these people have been your family, whether they have been your friends, whether they have been your bosses, teachers, whatever. Those people, when they realize that you have shut your doors and closed the borders and established very, very strong boundaries for yourself, you are going to lose so many people. And that shouldn't worry you, people, because usually when you start taking that kind of action, it is called self-love. It is not being selfish. People misunderstand self-love as being selfish. You can understand that you are loving yourself and respecting yourself and not taking any BS from anybody. You're closing your borders, you're putting very strong boundaries for yourself, and you are protecting yourself. And some people will not take this. Some people will not understand it. They will not take it. They are used to you with open borders. They are used to you saying yes. They are used to the yes man. They are not used to you saying no to whatever their needs were. And for the first time, you're going to shut down people, and people will think you're toxic. And some people will even think you're crazy, whatever. They'll call you names, but there's nothing to worry about, people. Self-love is not being selfish. Self-love is accepting yourself, accepting your flaws, accepting your mistakes, accepting your looks, the way you are, who you are, and understanding that it is about you and your own energy. Protecting your energy is your priority. And there's nothing wrong with that. And people, I can guarantee you, the very moment you are going to start loving yourself, the very moment you are going to stop asking for validation from your partners, from your fathers, from your brothers and sisters, the very moment you are going to take your power back and stop asking for validation and waiting for validation, somebody to validate you. Going online, some people are doing so many things online. You can always go online, speak your heart out, and don't wait for the views. Don't wait who is watching you, who is going to listen to you. You just go there, sit down, speak what you have to speak, say what you have to say. It is a part of self-love. You are doing something out of the heart, from the heart. You are not doing something because you're looking for likes, you're looking for somebody to like your content, or maybe sometimes you're waiting for somebody to validate whatever it is you said. Whatever it is you feel you want to say, you can say. Whatever it is you want to say, you want to do, you can do. Whatever it is you want to go, you can go. You can always say no if the job is not serving you. You can say no to your boss. And there's nothing wrong with that. I will not work in that position because it is not serving me. It is not for my highest good. And the boss will decide whether they want to keep you at the job or even they want to fire you. And you can still go for whatever it is, the decision they will take. So you protect yourself by saying no to the things that are not serving you. And believe me, people, the very moment you are going to choose self-love and understanding that you matter and you always have to put yourself first in front of everybody, that is the exact moment your life is going to change. It has worked for me, and I'm sharing it with you in this video and making you understand that at some point, if you have awakened, especially in my videos, I'm talking about narcissism and all these kind of toxic relationships. If you have awakened to the truth of who you are, if you have finally understood you are an empath, the next step you are going to find on your journey is called self-love. That is the moment you are going to start cutting off people. You are going to start choosing yourself. You are going to start putting yourself first. And do not worry, people, when people start falling off your circle, falling out of you, out with you. Do not worry about that, because that is going to indicate that anybody who is falling out with you, those are the exact individuals who are not supposed to be in your life. They were actually there by accident. They were never meant to be with you because they have always been taking advantage of you. But now that you're shutting the doors and you're choosing yourself and you're putting yourself first and you're going into self-love mode, you're loving yourself 100%. That is the exact moment when everything is going to overturn and work in your favor and your life will never be the same. Guys, that's it for my video. Let me know which way you're loving yourself. Let me know if you're a person who wakes up in the morning, go out there, buy yourself a nice meal. Go out there, take yourself on a holiday, take yourself on a vacation. Go out there, buy yourself a nice dress, a nice cloth. Go out there, speak your heart out, whether it's online, social media, whatever. You are doing everything within your power. And you're understanding that it is your right to love yourself 100%. Let me know what you think in the section below. Let me know if I'm talking to you. Other than that, people, it's been a lovely day. I hope to get in touch with you soon. Much love and blessings. And Desmo signing out.